I'm Dr. Sharad, consultant plastic surgeon. My main interest is cosmetic plastic surgery. In today's video, I'm going to take you through a surgery called gynecomastia. Gynecomastia is male breast enlargement, which can be seen in young pubertal males or older individuals. Gynecomastia happens, the reasons could be an estrogen excess, testosterone reduction, or more sensitivity to estrogen, depending on people's alcohol consumption, age, weight. The gynecomastia can be there. It can be a combination of fat or fat plus gland, which can be there in the individual. Yeah, as I mentioned earlier, that it can be alcohol, excess weight, obesity, and individuals wanting a correction depending on the amount of fat in that area. It is diagnosed by the individual initially, who comes to the surgeon asking for a remedy for that surgery by way of surgery. Now, when gynecomastia is assessed, first thing is a physical examination, followed by a hormonal evaluation to see if there is any underlying hormonal cause for it. The individual is also asked to have an ultrasound or a mammogram of the breast area. And if a suspicious nodule is seen, you might be asked to undergo a needle test to make sure that there is no malignancy or cancer underneath. After all these tests have been done and a hormonal imbalance has been ruled out or corrected, the surgical process or surgical option will be offered to you. You'll be asked to get a garment for it, which needs to be used at the time of the surgery, and any specific medication that might be like blood thinners, which you might be asked to stop to 1 to 2 weeks prior to it. Gynecomastia the approaches can vary, and it can be of different types, but grossly two types, which can be gynecomastia surgery with the incision along the areola, which is the black part of the surrounding the nipple, or through the axilla, through the axillary incision or incision, which is very tiny, through blunt cannulas, liposuction can be done. Sometimes the gland can be firm, needing a combination of open and a liposuction techniques, where in the liposuction technique the axillary port is used to suck out fat, and the open technique, wherein a cut through the areola, the extra gland or thick gland is removed. Subsequent to the surgery, you'll be asked to wear a garment for 6 weeks. And the garment makes sure that the skin shrinks well and sticks to the underlying muscle. There might be some bruising which lasts for the first 2 to 3 weeks and which takes time to resolve. And the final result is more obvious close to 6 weeks or longer in certain individuals sometimes. In some individuals, they might continue to gain weight, wherein the results of the surgery might not be that significant because the fat can reaccumulate in the area of the gynecomastia surgery. So you would need to be cautious about the amount of weight that you have gained. And you would be asked to do exercises to make sure that the chest wall muscles are more built up and an obvious manly or masculine look is obtained subsequent to the surgery, enhancing the benefits of the surgery. The benefits include an enhanced physical appearance, more masculine look, the increase in the chest wall, the obvious nature of the chest wall contour would have affected them mentally earlier with the gynecomastia, but now, but subsequent to the surgery, the confidence is on the higher side, and people will be able to engage in outdoor sports activities like swimming, and would not hesitate to dress in the open with their friends when they are much more comfortable subsequent to the surgery.